Permit me to use this opportunity to congratulate President Muhammadu Buhari on the confirmation of his victory by the traveler. The verdict testified to the intelligence of Nigerians who voted for a leader that is unwavering in his commitment to change the country as opposed to returning treasury voters to office to rob the country dry. It is instructive to note here that these same looters had promised mayhem and all hell on for Nigerians if they dare vote President Buhari. Their rejection of corruption, even in the face of mortal threat, is the reason we are able to gather here today. Because President Buhari has demonstrated that the trust the people have in him is not misplaced. We are aware that these bitter losers did all in their power to ensure that killings continue in the country, coupled with generating security situations. However, in 100 days of President Buhari being sworn in for another term of 4 years, it is apparent that politically masterminded killings across the country might have gathered momentum and increased in frequency. But there is a decline in such evil activities as we speak today. This rolling back of the forces of evil is all thanks to our security agencies, who, being inspired by the Commander-in-Chief, have continually evolved strategies to counter the many iterations of security breaches being rolled out by disgruntled politicians and their foot soldiers. The indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, is one of the clients supported by these NGOs that brand them as harmless agitators. Even the law of Nigeria is clear that it is a terrorist organization. Even if the law had not prescribed IPOB as a terrorist organization, it coordinated and organized attacks and attempted attack on senior Nigerian politicians as a confirmation of that group ideology of being reliant on violence to get things done. In the space of the first 100 days of his second term, President Buhari's government has also exposed the lie and shame that is the leadership of government has also that the leadership of Islamic movement in Nigeria, IMN, Sheikh Ibrahim Ezizaki, who in compliance with the court ruling was allowed to travel to India for medical tourism. It was that truth that finally exposed him as a fraud that was seeking an escape route to Iran in a bid to internationalize the activities of his proscribed IMN terrorist group in Nigeria. Nigeria are now enjoying respite since all Ezizaki pummeled his own medical treatment to expose that he was as smart as he had made the country to believe. The decision to outsource their terrorist activities to the Revolution Now movement has seen the raging protest leader, Sowore, ending up where he belongs. Nigeria